everyone. So now we are going to start our next topic of mathematics for class 2nd. So now we are going to start our next exercise, which is exercise 2.4. So first of all, we are having few questions based upon ascending order and then on descending order. As we know that in ascending order, what we do is we just arrange the numbers in the order of smallest to the biggest. So first of all, just find out the smallest number. As you can say that we are having the place value of 100 is which is same for everyone. So we are just going to check the tens place value of the numbers. So here it is 5, then 8, then 2, then 8, then 3, then 4. So just start, since we are having different digits on the tens place value. So what we are going to do is we are just going to keep them from smallest to the biggest one. So this is going to be your smallest number, 128. After that 3, 136. After that 4, which is 146. Then 5, 158. Then now we are having these two numbers which are having the same digits on your tens place value. So what we are going to do is we are just going to check the ones place of these numbers. So this is 3 and this is 5. Since 3 is smaller than that of the 5, so this whole number is going to be smaller than that of the 185. So what we are going to have after this 158 is your 183, then 185. After that, we are going to arrange the number in the order of decreasing order or in descending order. For that, what you are going to do is just, you can see that here we are having 3-digit, 3-digit, 1-digit, 3-digit, 3-digit, 3-digit. So this 1-digit number is definitely going to be your smallest one. Okay, so we are just going to put that in the last. After that, you can see that here the 100 place value is same for everybody. So just check the tens place. It is 9, 8, 3, 2 and 7. Since we are having different digits on tens place value, so we can judge all the numbers on the basis of their tens place value only. So the number which is having highest tens place value digit, so that is in all is going to be your largest one. So this is your largest one. After that, this which is having 8 at its tens place value. After that, this one which is having 7 at its tens place value. After that, this one which is having 3 at its tens place value. Then 127 which is having 2. And at last, we are going to have 4, since this is just a 1-digit number. Okay, so this is going to be the smallest among the given numbers. The third question is, Ravi has collected 165 stems. Sonam has collected 178 stems and Kavya has collected 139 stems. There are number of stems which are being collected by three different peoples, which are your Ravi, Sonam and Kavya. Write the number in ascending order. What you are going to do is you just need to arrange the number of stems which is given to you in ascending order, means from smaller to the bigger. This is going to be a smaller number, since you can see that we are having same number at it 100's place. So we are going to check the tens place. It is having 3, this is having 7 and this one is having 6. So this is going to be our smallest one. So we are going to write 139 first. After that, we are going to write 165 and then 178. Okay. So now write in the given blank who among the three has the least number of stems. Which is going, the least number among the three is going to be this. Which least means the smallest one. The number which you are having, the smallest one is going to be your least number. Okay, so this is your least number of stems they are having. Here are some examples of pair object that are in twos are said to be in pair. When you are talking about the numbers which are twos, that means we are having, we have in begin our number from 0, and when you are adding 2 into it, what you are going to get is 2. After that, moving 2 steps, what you are going to get is 4. After that, moving 2 step ahead, what you are going to get is 6. Then after 2, 8. Then after 2, 10. So the number which you are going to get when you are just moving two steps ahead, then that numbers are your even number. Like you can see that here we are having two pairs. So this is your even number. This is again your even and this is again your even. Now tick correct the boxes that have a pair, which is having a pair. So this is the pair of two. Here we are having sleepers which are in pair two. This are gloves which are also in pair of two. You can see that here we are having a picture of apple which is single. Here pencil which is also single. this we are having a mango which is again single, and now we are having these ants which is actually in pair or two in number. So this we just need to put a tick in this box. Draw as many triangles as the given number. What you are going to do is you just need to make the triangle according to the number which are given to you. Like here one is written, so we have made two triangles. Two is written, so we have made two triangles. Here we have made three triangles since three was given to you. Similarly, you can make number of triangles in the boxes given to you according to their number. Now ring the triangle that are in pair. After making pairs, check if any unpaired triangle is left in the box. Now what we are going to do is we are just going to make the pair of the numbers. Like here we are having just one, so it cannot form a pair. Here you are having two, so it can make a pair. Okay, so this is going to have a pair. Now here you can see that if I have made these three triangles, among this I have circled two, the pair of two triangles. After that we are left with one triangle. Okay, now if you are making four triangles, like I am having this four, so I have made pair of this two and these two, so I am having how many pairs? Two pairs, and I am not left with any triangle with me. Okay, so here we are going to have two pairs of triangle. After that we are having five triangles. I have made pair of these two and these two. What you are left with is this triangle. So we are just left with one triangle. So this can is the way of getting what even numbers are when you are arranging the objects in pair of two. And if you are not left with any of the object, then that is going to form your even number. So since we are not having any left triangle with us in this, so that means we are having pair of two, so this is your even number. Here we are left with this one triangle, so this is not your even number. In four we are just having pair of two, like this is your four, so we are having pair of two, so this is going to be even number since we are not left with any of the object, so this is your even number. Similarly six is your even number, eight and then 10, so these are your even numbers. And the boxes or the numbers in which we are left with few boxes and we were not properly making or forming the pairs, those are your odd numbers. As you can see that here we are not having a pair, so this is going to be your odd number. Here also we have made a pair of two, but after making the pair also we are just left with one triangle, so that is again going to be your odd number. So our odd numbers are 1, 3, similarly 5, 7 and 9. Okay, so now example number 3 is, write the number that comes just before 11. Is the new number even or odd? What you need to do is you just need to write a number which comes just before 11. Before means what you should do is you need to subtract 1 from it. So 11 minus 1 is going to be your 10. So we are having 10 which comes just before that of 11. Okay, so now the next question is this a number even or odd? Is that the even number or an odd number? Like I am having this 10 fingers in front of us. I have made the pair of two, then pair of two, then the pair of these two thumbs, then pair of these two, and then pair of these two. Now you can see that I am not left with any of my fingers since I have made first pair. This is my second pair. This is my third pair. After that, this is my fourth pair, and this one is my fifth pair. So I am not left with any number. So this is going to be your even number. So this 10 is your even number. Now is the number of years we have even or odd? The number of years you are having is, since we are having 2 years with us, which is 1 and 2, and we are having pair of it, so this is again going to be your even number. Now exercise 2.5. Circle the object in pair and find out whether the number given to you is odd or even. For representing even, we are going to put E in the circle, and if you are having odd, then you are going to put O. Like here you can see that we are having these pictures. This is pair of two, this is again pair of two, this is pair of two, and this is pair of two. Since we have made four pairs of two, so this is going to be an even number since we are not left with anything. Similarly, if you are having this, we are having pair of two, this is pair of two, and now we are left with this one ball, so this is going to be your odd number. Okay, similarly you can do the rest of your question. Now what you are going having is true or false. True means a sentence which is correct, okay, and the false is which is incorrect. So that for true or the correct statement we are going to put T, and for incorrect statement we are going to put F. Okay, Sia had even numbers of pencils, Ria had odd number of pencils. Riya can form pair but not Sia. Sia is having even number of pencils and Riya is having odd number of pencils. Okay? But Riya can form pair but Sia not. Is this sentence is correct? No. Because since Riya is having odd number of pencils, so she cannot form pair of that pencils. Okay? But Sia can because she is having even number of pencils. So if we are having even number, that can be formed into pairs. But if you are having odd number of things, then you cannot put them into pairs. So this is your incorrect statement. The number of eyes we have is odd. This is again your incorrect statement. Since we are having two eyes and these two eyes can make a pair of two. So since they are making pair of two, so they are going to be even in number. So this is again your false statement. Which of the following numbers are even? You just need to check out the numbers which are even. For that, we are having 3. This is your odd. This is again your odd. To check whether the number is your even or odd, for that just check the ones place of that number. Like you can see that the ones place of this number is 3. Here it is 6, 4, 7, 3, 6, 9, 0, 2, 9 and 3. If the ones place of any number is either 2, 4, 6, 8 or 0, then that number is going to be your even number. Just remember this thing, 2, 4, 6, 8 and 0. If the number is having any of these 5 digits, then that number is going to be your even number. So since this is 3, so it is your odd. We are having 6 at its ones place, so this is going to be even. We are having 4, this is going to be an even. 7, this is going to be an odd. 3, odd. 6, even. 9, odd. 0, even. 2, even. 9, odd. And 3 is again your odd. Okay. Now you need to encircle the odd numbers. The numbers which are not having 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8 at ones place, they will be your odd number. Like the number which are being left in the first question, that are going to be odd. So you can do this by yourself. Okay. So now the number after 26 is your 27 and it is an which number? So 27, as we know that the ones place of number, if that is 2, 4, 6, 8 or 0, then that is going to be even. Since we are having 27, which is having 7 at its ones place, so that is going to be your odd number. Okay. Now just take the correct answer. The even number between 60 and 63 is, the even number which comes in between 60 and 63 is going to be your 60. This number doesn't come. Yes, it is even, but it does not come between 60 and 63. Between means the number which comes in between them. Okay. So this isn't going to be your, this is even, but it isn't come between these numbers. 61, it comes between 60 and 63, but it is not your even number since it is having 1 at its ones place. 62, yes, it is an even number and yes, it comes in between these two numbers. So this is the number which is going to be here as your answer. Okay. So is the number of fingers we have even or odd? We are having 10 fingers and 10 is having 0 at its ones place. And they can form pair of 2 or 5. We are having 5 pairs of 2 in 10. So this is going to be your even number. Is the number of nose we have even or odd? Since we are just having one nose, so that is going to be your odd number. Now ordinal numbers 1 to 10. Look at the given picture. We can see that 10 aren't moving in a queue. Queue means in a line. Put a tick on the ant that is first in the queue and a cross out on the ant that is at last. What you are going to do is you are just going to put a circle on the first ant and a cross on the last ant. The ant nearest to the milestone is the first one. This is your first one and this one is your last one. And the ant nearest to the tree is on 10th place and that is your last one. So we are just going to put a circle on it and we are just going to cross it. Okay. Here first, second, third, fourth and so on are your ordinal numbers. Ordinal numbers tell us order or the position of the object. If you just want to tell or talk about the position of something, then we just use the ordinal number. Okay. As this is this ant is on first position, so the position of this ant is 1. which can be written as first position, this is the second position. Similarly, this is the fifth position and this is the tenth position and this one is your ninth position. Whenever you are talking about the position of that object, so that is going to be your ordinal number, okay? So, these are the position from 1 to 10, okay? Now, in the word number, let us write the position of the letter starting from our left. N is on which number? First. U is on second number. E is on fifth number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, 5 in ordinal number can be written as fifth. So, this is going to be your E is on fifth number and so on. Now, we are having next exercise, which is 2.6. What you are going to do is just look at the picture and color the third animal from your left in gray and fourth animal from your right in yellow. From my left, that means I need to begin from here. And from here, I just need to color the third animal in gray and the fourth animal from my right in yellow. From this left, I am going to color this is be my third, first, second and third. This is going to be a third animal, so I am going to put gray color into it, okay? And from my right, I just need to count the fourth animal. So this is going to be a first, this is going to be a second, this one is going to be a third and this one is going to be your fourth. So I am just going to put yellow color into it. So now we are going to move to the next questions. First of all, we are having what is the position of the monkey from the left? What is the position of bear from the right? You can just have a look on that picture and you can solve these questions by yourself, okay? So now we are going to link whatever we have learned about the ordinal number and the position with this one, okay? So write the name of the object and circle the letter mentioned in the box. What you are going to do is, we are having few pictures in front of us, we are just going to write the name of that object, okay, in the boxes provided to you. After that, what you are going to do is, we are just going to circle the number or the, sorry, circle the letter by the number which are being provided to you, okay. As you can see that this is having, we are going to circle second letter of the, that, like this is a picture of hat. So first of all, I am going to write the name of it, which is going to be H-A-T. After that, we are going to just circle the second letter of it. So that is going to be your A. The second letter of hat is going to be your A. Okay. After that, write the circle letters in sequence above their box numbers in the given space. As you can see that we have been provided with few space downwarded. So we are just going to put the circled number in a proper sequence. So first of all, I am having, like you can see, this one is your first. This is the picture of pen. So I have written pen. Okay. And first letter of this is going to be your P. So I have circled it. Okay. So I have written P here. After that, we are having this hat. I have written H A T. And since we need to circle the second letter, which is your A, so I have circled A. After that, this is your necklace. So this is going to be N E C K L A C E. And what you need to do is, you need to circle the seventh letter. So that is going to be your 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6 and 7, which is your C. So what you are having is C from this one. After that, this is the picture of a cake. What you need to write is C A K E, and you need to circle the third letter, which is your K. 1, 2, 3. So I have circled K. From here I have got A. From here I have got C, and from here I have got K. Similarly, you can just take the other letters also from each and every box and just try to fill these boxes and try to make a new word, okay? So now, is the number of the letters even or odd? These are the questions which are totally based upon this example. So first of all, just try to make the word, and after just solve it. Now we need to revise what we have learned. Now we are done with our chapters. We are just going to revise whatever we have learned till now, okay? So first of all, we are having the number that comes just before that of 130. Just to find out the number which comes just before it, what we do is just subtract 1 from it. So that is going to be a 129. Similarly, you need to write the other number also. This is the thing. Fill in the blanks with these two symbols for the greater one or the larger one. Find out the number which is the greater one and just keep the symbol mouth open on the side of the larger number. As you know that 62 and among 62 and 75, the larger number is 75. So we are just going to put this symbol over here, since this symbol is having mouth open towards this side. So this is what we need to do in this. Write the number from the list as directed. Also write whether it is even or odd. First of all, we are having list of few numbers. You need to find out the greater number and then the smallest number, and then just find out whether that number is your even number or an odd number. So first of all, this is a list of your number. As you can see that the 100 place value is same for every number. We are just going to move to the tens place value. Here we are having 4, then 6, then 5, then 8, and then 9, and then again 5. Okay, so just compare the greatest number. Greatest number should be the number which is having highest 10 place digit, which is your 9. So this is going to be your greatest number. So I have written number over here, which is your 195. And just tell me whether that number is your even number or odd number. Since the ones place digit of 195 is 5, and for being it to be even, what we need is 0, 2, 4, 6, and 8. But since we are having 5, so that is going to be your even number. Now just do this by yourself. Mental maths. Take correct. This put the sign at the correct answer. Okay. So the 135 is greatest than 127, 145, and 195. 135 is greater than that of 127, since these are already greater than that of the 135. So that is going to be greater than 127. The place value of 4 in 146 is, place value of 4 in 146 is going to be, this is your 1's place, this is your 10's place. So the place value is going to be your 40, which is this. So you just need to put a correct tick sign in this. Now the second one is, write the letters that are missing in the number names. Also write the numbers in the blank given. You need to write the missing numbers in this. Like you can see that here it is NI. Which is, since this is a one number, so this is going to be your 19. NINETEEN. And the number is this, 1919. Similarly, this is your 1. After that, this is the place value of that number, which is 100. So this is going to be your HUNDRED. After that, we are having this 15. FIFTEEN. So the number which is going to form is 115, that is 115. So we are going to write 115 in front of it. Now we are having few hots which are in the school skating competition. Aman was on fourth position behind Rohit. Rohit stood third in the race. What was Aman's position? It was on four positions, so that is going to be the fourth position. Okay, so the position of Aman is going to be fourth.